Namaste, I'm Smita Jayakar. Let's start with the Guru Mantra. Please close your eyes. Om Jyoti Rupaya Paramasakhaya Paramanandaya Dada Shri Ji Namo Namaha. Om. What is oneness? When we read spiritual books and listen to people who talk on spirituality, a lot of people use this word oneness. You have to feel oneness with the universe. You have to feel oneness with everything that is. And we really don't know the meaning of what is oneness. So oneness has four levels. The first level is oneness with yourself. So when we look at ourselves in the mirror, we always find faults with ourselves. Why am I short? Why am I not tall? I'm thin, I'm fat, I've got curly hair, I've got pimples on my face, I'm dark. You're luckier than me. You've got so much more than what I have got. All these kind of thoughts keep coming to yourself. And you're always rejecting yourself each time these kind of thoughts come. What we need to do is we need to accept yourself the way you are. You accept your life the way your life is. If you sit comparing yourself with somebody else, you will be suffering all your life. So this is what is oneness with yourself. When you accept yourself to the fullest and your life with all its pain and suffering to the fullest. That's called oneness with yourself. When you're one with yourself, then you go on to the next step, is oneness with the other. Because till you don't love yourself, it is impossible for you to love the other. We have to love ourselves the way we are. The divine has created us in this particular form for a reason. If you're short or fat, or if you have this kind of problems or this kind of realities of your life or experiences of your life, they are there for a reason, for you to learn something. If you keep on complaining, you do not learn. And life is a huge learning. So first level is oneness with yourself. After you have come to terms with yourself, you start loving yourself. And once you love yourself, you come to the second level, is oneness with the other. Now what is oneness with the other? Oneness with the other is when you understand yourself, you also realize that you have pain, insecurities, comparison, judgments, anger, all these are there with you. So when you connect with the other, you realize and understand that the other person also is going through the same emotions what you're going through. So you are at this point a little more sensitive towards the other person's problems. Otherwise, when the other person anytime comes to you with any kind of a problem, you will say, oh my God, I have no patience for this person. I have enough of my own. I don't have patience to deal with this. But when you come to terms with the second level, oneness with the other, you are at least a little more patient with that other. You may not have a solution to that person's problems, but at least you're sensitive to listening to what the other person has to say. This is oneness with the other. You identify with his pain. You identify with the sorrow. You do not reject him. You're not indifferent with that person. This is oneness with the other. When you come to the third level, you are in oneness with everything that is. That means inanimate objects also. Now, what is to be in oneness with things which are not living? How can you be in oneness with that? I'll give you an example. We have a cup of tea every day. right? Do you know where the tea leaves come from? Which part of the earth is that plant grown? We don't know. Whether it's from India, whether it's from outside India, we have no idea. That particular shrub that is grown on that plot, which is on the earth, there are so many worms, insects, which play a role to make that shrub healthy or unhealthy, whatever. Then there are the natural elements. The wind, the rain, the sun, the tide, etc. are working on that plant. Then comes, when the plant grows up, human beings which are working on the plant. They pluck the leaves. Somebody goes and collects them in one vessel maybe. The other person goes and shreds them. There's a lot of division done on it. There's a lot of work that is done on that. So many processes go along with it. Then finally it is packed and etc. etc. Then it comes to a shop which is close by. Then you or a domestic help or somebody goes and buys and gets that packet to your house. Then either you or somebody else prepares the tea and gets it for you. Do you realize the processes of the universe and the people in the universe have gone in getting you one cup of tea? You're obliged to so much for just one cup of tea. Those people you will never meet again to go and say thank you to them. You can't say thank you to the universe, which you don't do. So do you know you are an obligation of such a lot, just one cup of tea? The milk that you pour inside has another story altogether. So do you realize that whatever you do in life and whatever you have in life, you are obliged to so many people of the universe whom you cannot even offer your gratitude. So, what I mean by this third level is oneness with all that is and with oneness with inanimate things is what you have in your life is not only because of you. It's not you are a big person, you are a rich person, you have all these amenities. It's not only because of you or your hard work. There are so many things in the universe which are responsible for you, where you are and how you are and why you are in that situation. If you realize this, and when you realize this, this humbles you. You always feel that you're in gratitude to everything that the universe has offered to you. So when somebody offers you even a glass of water, please remember that glass has a huge story behind it, water has a huge story behind it, and the person offering you water also has a huge story behind it. So always be in gratitude, whether it is animate stuff or inanimate stuff, always be in gratitude. It's a very, very humbling thought and very humbling effect on you. So you never start feeling egoistic. Oh, I have done this. It's because of me that such a big, huge empire has stood up. No, it's not because of you. There are so many people behind this whole scene whom you don't know, who you'll never see in your life. When by the time you reach this third level, you are in a very high spiritual state actually. Then comes the last state. Last is oneness with the Almighty. Oneness with the Almighty is when you start feeling one with the whole creation, with the whole universe. When you connect with that someone up above. In Hindi we say, Nar se Narayan tak. From the cell, from the micro cell to the macro cell. It's a whole connection with the whole. It's a connection from the micro cell to the macro cell. You have to be in connect with your divine. This is your last bus stop of spirituality. In fact, so many people when they start on this path, they don't know what is the end of the road. The end of the road is you have to be one with that entire universe, with that light, with that Almighty. That is your last bus stop. So to connect with the divine is to be an awakened human being. Just now everyone is sleeping. You know, just the other day somebody remarked, oh Smita, you've changed so much. So I keep telling them, I've not changed, I have woken up. So my dear friends, my suggestion or request to you is to just wake up. Be an awakened human being. Be in awareness all the time. Now that I've told you all these steps of oneness, next time when you eat something, when you do something, when you connect with someone, please remember this, that you need to connect. And before that, you need to connect with yourself. And the last of it is connect with the divine, someone up there, to that light, to the creator, whoever the creator is. And always be in gratitude to the creator. Thank you.